20 by 10 by 10 centimeter. Its weight is 3 to 3.5 kg. Thank you, sir, for listening our presentation and listening. Thank you, sir.
Okay, very good. Any question from student side? Hello? From the student side, if you have any question, then ask. Students, happy to do the answer. Okay, so from my side, the presentation is good enough to understand how to prepare a brick. Okay, and that types of brick, like a first class brick, second class brick, are the classes and their characteristics. That for the first class brick, the minimum strength is 10.5. That is, we need to understand the characteristics, or you can say the property of a brick. Okay, so it will help you. There is a some correction. Okay, in a reference, you need to add your book reference. In a title slide, there is a, you need to add your subject. Okay, basic civil engineering with the subject code ES5. Okay, and I think 122 student, explain any slide. Hello.
What, sir?
122 number is present or not?
Yes, sir. 122.
Are they present, kar you?
Yes, sir. Last.
Last topic only.
Yes, sir.
Okay, next group. Group number two is rescheduled. So next group is group number three. And also, when you start a presentation, when you start, then turn on your camera. Okay. Group number three, ID number 130, 167, 203, 163, and 140.
Yes, sir.
One present on the screen.
Sir, ID number 167.
167. Okay, now you can see the screen and turn on your camera if you start the presentation or any other screen. जिनका प्रेजेंटेशन खत्म हुआ है उनको निकलना नहीं है प्रेजेंटेशन में से. ओके, वो कंटिन्यूअसली ज्वाइन रहे. हेलो, 167 number.
Hello.
Yes.
A very warm welcome to one and all present here. I am Shrey Aminjay from Division 2 Civil Department.
Presentation mode mein chala gaya. ओके, आपका मोबाइल है वो रोटेट कर दो, एवरीवन कैन सी योर पर्सन. योर स्क्रीन इज विजिबल, जस्ट इन अ प्रेजेंटेशन मोड लैंडस्केप कर दो.
सॉरी सर,
आपका जो मोबाइल है ना वो अभी पोर्ट्रेट में है, तो उसको लैंडस्केप में कर दो। ओके
रोटेट कर दो।
हाँ रोटेट। यस सर, नाउ ओपन योर प्रेजेंटेशन। यस वेरी गुड। नाउ देयर इज अ प्रेजेंटेशन मोड इन अ टॉप। ओके, जो सर्च के राइट में ना वहाँ पे प्रेजेंटेशन है, यहाँ पे नहीं, प्रेजेंटेशन में चले जाओ। हाँ यहाँ पे दिख रहा है आपको? हाँ वेरी गुड। नाउ इट्स ओके।
Shall I start?
Yes.
A very warm welcome to one and all present here. I am Amin Shreje from Division 2 Civil Department. Today we are here to give a presentation on topic where we were assigned, mortar. Before okay. that, I would like to thank our here. Professor Dhaval Parmar for guiding and supporting us.
Okay, here. You need to wear mine. Okay, Professor Jala sir, Professor Pinaki sir, just आपको रेफरेंस दिया था, ओके, नॉट अ प्रिपेयर्ड बाय कवर एंड ऑल दिस, जस्ट आपको आईडी से प्रिपेयर बाय मींस व्हाट, किसने प्रिपेयर किया है प्रेजेंटेशन, उसका नाम आपका, गाइडेड बाय हु, कि किसने गाइड किया है, तो मैंने आपको टॉपिक दिया है, मैंने आपको कंटेंट दिया है, ऑन दैट बेसिस यू प्रिपेयर योर प्रेजेंटेशन, ओके, सो ओनली देयर इज अ वन गाइडेड बाय डबल परमार एंड प्रिपेयर बाय योर फाइव स्टूडेंट, अंडरस्टूड? हेलो,
यस सर।
हाँ और ये सब निकाल दो। ओके, यू एक्स्ट्रा एंड यू नीड टू ऐड योर सब्जेक्ट बेसिक सिविल इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट एंड ऑल दिस। ओके नेक्स्ट लाइन।
ओके सर,
नेक्स्ट।
सो आवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक विल बी कमेंट्स बाय 203 आईडी नंबर। आईडी 203।
I'm audible?
Yes. Okay, आप स्क्रॉल करोगे तो मुझे सब कुछ यहाँ पे दिखेगा आपका डिस्प्ले। ओके, तो आप प्रेजेंटेशन मोड ही ओपन रखो 167। अभी जो भी व्हाट्सएप पे चल रहा है।
What is mortar? Mortar क्या है? Mortar is a workable paste used to wind construction blocks together and fill the gaps between them. The words come from Latin mortisum, means crust.
The camera on karo, turn on
mortar camera. May
hello 203 number, aapka camera on karo. Okay, very good.
Mortar may be used to wind masonry blocks of stones, bricks, etc. Mortars becomes hard when it sets, resulting in rigid aggregate structure. Mortar can also be used to fix our points masonry when the original mortar has washed away. Composition of mortar. Modern mortars are typically made from a mixture of sand, a binder such as cement or lime, and water. Thanks. Next. I would like to invite 167.
Okay, next number.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, it's not Matan actually, it's Kirti Kumar, Prajapatistan.
Okay.
Hello, sir. Sir, composition of mortar is my topic and 203 a topic le lido ane next mane inform pan na karyo ke ana pachi mare a karvanu
che. Okay, okay. Continue. You need to understand your mechanism. Okay, this is the group work. That's why.
Sir, composition of mortar thi pachi start karyo.
Okay, yes, we can.
Okay.
No, continue karo.
Hello everyone present at to here. I am Kirti Kumar Prajapati from Division 2, ID number 20C130, and I will to present on the topic of composition of mortar. What is mortar? Composition means rachana kalvi. Composition of mortar. A modern mortar are typically made from a mixture of sand, a binder such as a cement or lime. Cement mortar is a mixture of a cement, sand, and a water in a prop. Water in appropriate proportion. Cement and the sand. In this, we can see in this picture, cement and three part of sand, one part of cement. Cement and the sand in appropriate proportion. Mix by the help of the powder in dry state, and then the water is added in this mixture, and mix it by using a powder and homogeneous paste of cement and the mortar is formed. Next, uses of mortar. In this picture, we can see mortar are used in various type. Mortar as a binding material, plastering, pointing, masonry joint, cementary sir. Cement mortar is used for the stone and brick both masonry work, and it's also used for the plastering, repairing work, grouting, and deterring work. Next, ideal mortar adheres completely and durability to all the masonry unit to provide stability, remain workable long enough to enable the operative to set the masonry unit right to line and level. This implies good water retentivity. Stiffens sufficiently quickly to permit the laying of the unit to proceed smoothly, and provides rapid development of strength and adequate strength when hardened. It resistant to the action of environmental factors such as frost and or abrasion, and distributive effect of chemical salt such as a sulfate attack. Resist the penetration of brain, accommodates movement of the structure, accommodates irregularity in size of masonry unit, contribute to the overall aesthetic impression. Ideal cement mortar ratio is 1:2 to 1:6 or more by volume, and depend on the strength required or work. And I would like to next topic will be present by Shrey, ID number 160.
Hello. Yes. Let's talk about its multiple properties. Number one, workability. Workability may be defined as the behavior of a mixture in respect to all of its properties required during application, subsequent working, and finishing. The mixture we made should be easy to use. It should be easy to spread on the masonry unit, and should be easy to positioning of the masonry unit without movement due to its own weight and weight of additional forces. The stiffness and hardening. The progression of stiffness, or known as the workable life in European standard, refers to the gradual change from fresh or plastic mortar to set mortar. Hardening refers to the subsequent process whereby the set mortar progressively develops strength. Here are some properties of hardened mortar. Durability of mortar may be defined as its ability to endure aggressive conditions during its design life. A number of potentially destructive influences always interact with mortar, including water, frost, soluble salts, temperature change, etc. In general, as the cement content increases, so will its durability or its lifetime. Air entrainment of mortar improves resistance of freeze thaw damage. Its compressive strength. The use of too much cement will produce a more rigid mortar, which may result in cracking pass through units of mortar joint and stress are imposed. The use of appropriate mortar should not result in cracking, but any that does occur will tend to follow the joints, which will be easier to repair. Flexural strength, or also known as the modulus of rupture, is a measure of its strength and tensile strength in bonding. The traditional masonry construction tended to be massive relative to modern structures, typically with very thick walls. This meant that the mass or bulk generally resisted the various force applied. The development of modern masonry units and advance in mortar technology have led to more slender structures, which are more vulnerable to lateral forces like wind load. Let's talk about the precautions while making mortar. Mortar should be mixed in small quantities so that it can use conventionally before it starts setting. Never use the mortar which is already set. In masonry construction work, usable bricks or stone should be soaked in water very thoroughly for at least 12 hours before they are used in work in mortar, so that it will prevent the absorption of moisture from the mortar before it sets. Mortar should not contain excess water. It should be as stiff as it can use without inconvenience. Fresh water should be used in mortar preparation. You should avoid all oil, dust, alkalis, etc. Use of seawater in mortar mixture can be avoided. The joint should be filled with mortar. Now, the mixing of mortar and the rest topics will be presented by Hardik.
हेलो सर, आई एम हार्दिक पटेल. माय आईडी नंबर VC 163. टाइप्स ऑफ मोर्टार. मोर्टार आर क्लासिफाइड ऑन द बेसिक ऑफ द फॉलोइंग. Bulk density is the weight of soil in a given volume. Bulk density આપેલ કદમાં માટીનું વજન દર્શાવે છે. અને સેકન્ડ ટાઈપ, કાઇન્ડ ઓફ બાઇન્ડિંગ મટીરિયલ. થર્ડ, નેચર ઓફ એપ્લિકેશન ફોર સ્પેશિયલ રિક્વાયરમેન્ટ. નેક્સ્ટ, એડવાન્ટેજ એન્ડ ડિસએડવાન્ટેજ ઓફ મોર્ટાર. એડવાન્ટેજ એન્ડ ડિસએડવાન્ટેજ. એડવાન્ટેજ, સ્ટ્રોંગ ઇન કમ્પરેશન, રિસીડ ટેમ્પરેચર એન્ડ ફલ્કેશન. મોસ્ટ ઓફ વોલ ડુ નોટ રિક્વાયર પેન્ટિંગ. ફાયર પ્રોટેક્શન ડ્યુ ટુ ફોર્મેટ ઓન નોન કમ્બિશન મટીરિયલ. લેડિંગ કન્ટ્રીબ્યુટ ટુ ગ્રીન બિલ્ડિંગ ધેટ હેઝ લો ઇમ્પેક્ટ ઓન નેચર. બ્લોક્સ આઉટ નોઇઝ મોર ઇફેક્ટલી ધેન અધર ટ્રેડિશનલ બિલ્ડિંગ મટીરિયલ સચ ટ્રિમર. Use of locally available of labor. Disadvantage. Observe moisture when raining. Extreme weather causes masonry to degrade materials such as wall surface, decolonize due to frost damage. Problem in large opening. Lack of education in masonry due to heavy weight. Large foundation is required also. Cracking and settlement of many occur. Next, history of mortar. Mortar is one of the oldest building material, enable large structure to be constructed from small, easy to handle components. It was used by Romans, Greek, and Egypt, and the oldest example made it back as far as 10,000 years in Israel. Thank you for your attendance. Thank you for listening to me.
What about the 14 number?
See, sir, we have tried to contact him, but he is giving no response. Only four of us have made this presentation.
Okay, so right now, I put an absent remark. Okay, inform me.
Okay. Okay.
Contact me. Okay. Next group. Okay, any question from the student side? Lecture में कोई question नहीं होता है, सो नहीं sir. बराबर ना? Okay, so the presentation is good enough to understand what is the motor and list classification and the types of motor. Okay, very good. Okay, next group, group number 4. Who can present their screen from group number 4, 91, 93, 101, 102 and 110? Hello.
Sir, hello sir. I am not able to share a screen.
Okay, wait. 91. Now. Okay.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Now. Okay. Sir, I am audible?
Yes.
First of all, good morning to all, and thank you for giving me this chance. I am Koli Manish, 091, and my group mates are Uraj Patel, Anand Danari, Paija Parth, and Devang Patel. Thank you to guide us, Parmar sir. Our today's project topic is principle of planning and architecture. If we talk about the introduction of both topics, planning, it is the arrangement of various components and units of the building in a systematic manner or according to their functional purpose. Planning is necessary for every building to construct it a proper way and to increase their lifetime. The second topic is architecture. It is nothing but the art and science of designing building from its micro to macro level. In simply, we can say that architecture gives the look of the building, how it looks from front side or inside or interior of the building. Principle of planning. While planning a building, principle of planning should be considered a close association with theoretically any practical aspects. There should be some flexibility in adopting these planning principles. There are generally 11 principles of planning, likewise aspect, prospect, privacy, grouping, roominess, circulation, elegance, flexibility, sanitization, economy and practical consideration, and furniture requirement. Now I give the brief about each aspect, each principles. The first one is aspect. In this principle, different buildings should be located as per their utility, keeping in mind that the direction of sun and wind. It is to get the maximum advantage of natural sources and various material. For example, southwest direction or southeast direction, bath or WC is in north direction. Direction matter to the building according to their location of various components and units. Properties prospect. A building is said to have a prospect when it presents a good and pleasant appearance when seen from the outside. This gives a good appearance and a feeling of cheerful to the people living outside or inside. This can be done by placing windows and door at their proper place and at a require a notable feature. In figure 1, we can see that there is a various types of location of windows, and its view are also different. And in downward figure, you can say that by locating windows at one of the bottom, it's look quite simple and good. So this is the prospect. Now third one and most important one is privacy. This is the one of the essential and important principle of planning. Privacy can be from one part to another part of the same building, or can be from a neighbor building. It maintains the privacy of individual and house. In case of residential building, privacy can be secured by planning the entrance, proper grouping, and providing verandas and corridors. Now I like to invite my group mate for the further presentation. Vraj.
Good morning, sir. I am 20C093 Vraj Patel, and I will be presenting the further slides. Grouping. As the name itself tells us the meaning, it is the arrangement of various rooms with relation of their functions. Its purpose is to provide comfort and ease to the people living. In residential building, the example is how a washroom should be attached so that it does not disturb the person living in the other room. Roominess. In short, it means getting maximum advantage from minimum dimension of the room. Roominess is affected by length, width, and height. Shape and size of the room are very important for roominess. As shown in the figure, the rectangle has more roominess than the square in area. Circulation. It is access in or out of the room for internal movement inside the building. It must be short, bright lighted both day and night, and it should not affect the privacy. Examples are passage, stairs, corridor, lobbies, hall, etc. Elegance. Before we enter the building, the first we notice is how the building looks from outside. This changes the mentality of person before entering the building. Elegance depends upon width, height, proportion of door and windows, and the material used to make the building. For better elegance, selecting superior building material, using polished marble, providing sunshades, balconies, increases the elegance. And the further slide will be explained by my other groupmate.
Hello sir, I am 20C101 Anand Anani. Flexibility, it means a room be so planned for one function that even if required, it can be used for other purpose. For present and future requirement of family changes the family expand. Like example, like one man marriage after their 20 years after some years they have children and they separate in two rooms. To arrange a large gathering of people, small rooms are converted to a big hall by shifting wooden partition. Sanitization. Sanitization means to make a provision for lights, thermal comfort, insulation, and other service. For the proper light, clean lines, ventilation, and sanitary units in the building. For lighting, it is important for the point of view of illumination and hygiene. Light may be natural or artificial, and clean lines. It include cleaning availability in a building. Economic and particle consideration. It means the economy may not be a principle of planning, but definitely a factor of affecting it. The building should have minimum floor area, maximum unity, and it will reduce the cost and hence will be economical. Economical should not be achieved at the cost of strength, otherwise the useful life of will reduce. Furniture requirement, it means furniture is the function of requirement of a room and necessary for every building. Every room of a residential unit has to perform certain function or for which necessary furniture items are required. It should be seen that placing type, size and extent of such furniture items do not obstruct doors, windows and circulation area. Now sir, I request to my group member for explain further slide.
Hello, namaskar sir. My name is Parth. My ID number 20CE102. I explain principle of architecture. An architecture principle is the principle of a concept that is made part of an architecture, total concept of a structure or system. An architecture principle leads all the design work at an architecture firm. General seven principles of architecture like balance, rhythm, emphasis, proportion and scale, movement, contrast, unity. First, balance. Part of the design are equally distributed to create a sense of stability. Both physical and visual balance exist. Types, symmetrical or formal balance. See the figure like that Taj Mahal. Second, asymmetrical or informal balance like that Nike symbol. Radial balance. So the figure below. Second figure, vertical balance like that capital of A, horizontal balance like the capital of B. Second, rhythm. It is defined as a unified movement characterized by a pattern, repetition or alternation of formal elements or motifs in the same or a modified form. Hence, rhythm is a repetition or element such as line, shape, pattern, colors, or texture, resulting in an organized movement. Types, regular rhythm, graduated rhythm, random rhythm, or gradated rhythm. Third, emphasis. It is a strategy that aims to draw the viewer's attention to the specific design element, like that purpose. This feature in a design to attract one size, the focal point. Construction process like that emphasis can be achieved through size, placement, shape, color, or use of line. Next principle explained to our group member by Devang Patel.
Good morning, sir. I am 20C110, Devang Patel. Proportion and scale. Proportion is the relation of two or more elements in a design, while scale refers to the size of something compared to the reference standard or to the size of something else. Comparative relationship between element in a design with respect to size. 3:5 ratio is known as the Walden mean. Next, moment. Moment is the change in position. Directional moment can be created with a value pattern, where it is not the architecture that is the true of is moving, but the eye, mind, imminent body of force. Next, contrast. Contrast means the difference between two objects, color or place. Example, light and dark colors, smooth and rough structures, large and small shape. Purpose, contrast can be used to create visual interest and drama in the artwork. Contrast can be created with color, proportion, scale, structure. Next, unity. Unity is achieved by the constant use of lines, color, material, and texture within a design. Unit is the most important principle of achieving order, which is the aim of design. Purpose, success in composing unit means bring symmetric, functional, and visual at the same time. Thank you for listening me and my group members.
That's all from ourselves, sir. Thank you to guide from us and listening carefully. Thank you, sir.
Okay. A nice presentation. And all content are covered on the principle of building architecture. Just one correction is there, just the format or the slide presentation. Just correct it. Okay, just you need to justify. Otherwise, your presentation is good enough to that your topic. Very good.
Sorry, sir.
आपको सिर्फ आपका जो प्रेजेंटेशन है उसको जस्ट जस्टिफाई करना है ओके जो फॉर्मेट है ना ओके उसको जस्ट कंट्रोल जे करके सेलेक्ट करके कंट्रोल जे कर देना आपका प्रेजेंटेशन एक लाइन में एक जस्टिफाई हो जाएगा ओके
मींस सारे जो ट्रांजिशन है सेम होने चाहिए सर
नहीं ट्रांजिशन नहीं वो लाइक ओपन करो आपका प्रेजेंटेशन ओपन करो
ओके वन मिनट सर
Next slide.
Yes, sir.
Okay, यहाँ पे देखो बस बस तक तो बस 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 लड़ी तक बस लड़ने ज़्यादा समझे. Okay, now you can see that planning के नीचे जो paragraph start होता रहा है. Okay, वो start भी line हो रही है, वो भी अलग-अलग starting point है उसके. और एंड हो रहा है वो भी अलग पॉइंट पे एंड हो रहा है तो अगर आप कंप्यूटर में आप सेलेक्ट करके कंट्रोल जे दबा दोगे तो आपकी लाइन होगी वो प्रॉपर एक ही डायरेक्शन में जाएगी
सर ओके एक ही लाइन दिस इज मेड इन फ्रॉम अ मोबाइल दैट्स व्हाई नॉट डन इन दैट मैनर
ओके डोंट वरी बट आपको ये करना होगा ओके टू इंप्रूव योर प्रेजेंटेशन
सर डेफिनेटली इन नेक्स्ट
यस बिकॉज़ आपको मुझे सबमिट करना है तो जो भी मैं आपको करेक्शन दूंगा वो करेक्शन करके फिर मुझे सबमिट करना है ओके एवरीवन
मींस जो हमारा सर एंडिंग हो रहा है वो भी लाइन में होना चाहिए ना ऐसा ना जो हमारे ये लाइन के जो एंडिंग है
हां देखो वन मिनट आई विल शो यू इन माय प्रेजेंटेशन वेट Okay, you can see that from the my presentation. Okay. the line or point. You can see the start point and the end point is in the, for each line the same. Okay, if you're not in a line, okay, like there is a roughly, like look like your presentation look like this. Okay, wait, not it looks like this. Okay, the second point. Is it? Hello?
Sir, I gave a tab for the next point, I think. There are some different points for that, I think I okay. Give the tab.
Okay, so what you need to do, just select or your, if you are worried, just control J or just here, justify, you need to just justify, okay. There is the option, justify.
Yes.
Okay.
Sir,
okay.
I understand, but I am saying that the tab I given that is for justifying the different point. Means from where I tab that, from that point, there is a different point. So I have okay. To just.
Don't worry,
so
correct.
That I give the space.
Okay, don't worry,
okay,
correct it. And send it.
Okay.
Send it.
Okay. Okay.
And every group member, please correct that correction, okay, that I will give one. Okay, and after
sir,
that.
Where we have to send it?
Mail me, via mail.
Oh.
Okay. Okay, next group. Group number 5, group number 6. 155, 158, 159, 170, and last number is 120.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
159, yes. Sharing screen.
Who, 159?
Yes, sir.
Now we can start the presentation.
Sir, screen is visible?
No. Now it is open a presentation. Go to landscape presentation.
Visible.
Yes. And minimize this MS.
What sir?
वो आप साइड में जो लोगो दिख रहा है ना MS Team का, उसको minimize कर लो अगर possible है.
Yes sir.
Okay now it is.
Hello student. I am Sahil Vadalia. My group member is Gohil Jignesh, Prajapati Rutik, Gohil Mayur, Chaki Amin. We are present a PPT. Our topic is types of building, components of building and its function. First of all, thank you to Professor Dhawal Sir Parmar who guided me for this presentation. Introduction. First of all, introduction of building. Building or house is one of the basic necessary of life. Everyone wishes to live in splendid building and also wishes to own a building or house, however small or big it may be. It is also an indicator of civilization, of the social status and progress of a country. Construction techniques also affects the economy as well as quality. As a civil engineer, mainly concerned with the construction of buildings, it is necessary for him to acquire good knowledge of construction of various components of the buildings. Classification of buildings. National Building Code of India. National Building Code of India dwara building na prakaro nakki karvamaan aavya chhe. There are two types of building based on occupation, purpose served by buildings, and second part is based on structure according to structural system. The first of all is based on occupancy, purpose served by buildings. Here is a 10 parts of type of building. Group A, residential building. Group B, education building. Group C, institutional building. Group D, assembly building. Group E, business building. Group F, mercantile buildings. Group G, industrial building. Group H, storage building. Group J, hazardous building. First of all, group A resident bahar ja se. First of all, group A residential building. All those building in which sleeping echo providing by dwelling permanent or temporary with or without cooking or dining facilities are called a residential building. જેમ કે આપણે જે બંગલોસ ફ્લેટ રોઆઉ જેમ આપણે રહીએ છીએ તે બધાને રેસિડેન્ટલ બિલ્ડિંગ કહેવાય. મેઇન પાર્ટ ઓફ ટાઈપ્સ ઓફ બિલ્ડિંગ. ગ્રુપ બી એજ્યુકેશનલ બિલ્ડિંગ્સ. ઓલ ધોઝ બિલ્ડિંગ્સ વિચ આર મેન્ટ ફોર ઇમ્પાર્ટિંગ ટ્રેનિંગ ઓર પ્રોવાઇડિંગ એજ્યુકેશનલ ફેસિલિટીઝ રાઇટ ફ્રોમ નર્સરી ઓર પ્રાઇમરી ટુ યુનિવર્સિટી લેવલ સચ એઝ સ્કૂલ કોલેજીસ યુનિવર્સિટી ટ્રેનિંગ ઇન્સ્ટિટ્યૂટ પોલિટેક્નિક્સ એન્જિનિયરિંગ કોલેજ એન્ડ મેડિકલ કોલેજ લાઇબ્રેરી અને એટ્રેક્ષા. જેમ કે આપણે એજ્યુકેશનલ માટે જે કોલેજ આપણે ભણીએ છીએ તે એજ્યુકેશનલ બિલ્ડિંગમાં આવે. નેક્સ્ટ ઇઝ ગ્રુપ સી ઇન્સ્ટિટ્યુશનલ બિલ્ડિંગ. ધીસ બિલ્ડિંગ્સ આર ડીલિંગ્સ વિથ હેલ્થ કેર. ધીસ ગ્રુપ ઓફ બિલ્ડિંગ્સ ઇન્કલુડ સચ એઝ બિલ્ડિંગ્સ ઓર પાર્ટ હેર ઓફ ફોર ધ પર્પઝ સચ એઝ મેડિકલ હેલ્થ રિકવરિંગ હેલ્થ આફ્ટર ઇલિનેસ ફિઝિકલ્સ એન્ડ મેન્ટલ ડાયસિસિસ કેર ઓફ ઇન્ફાન્ટ્સ ઓફ એજ્ડ ડેટેનેશન એન્ડ એટ્રેક્ષા. These buildings are example of hospitals, homes of aged people, orphanages, jails, mental hospital, reformatories, and etc. Group D assembly buildings. These groups include any building or part of buildings where group of people of assemble or gather for amusement, recreation, social, regal gees, patriotic or such other. Example like assembly halls, exhibition halls, theater, auditorium, temples, churches, etc. are the example of the these categories of the buildings. Thank you for listening me. Next is ID number 20CE155.
Yes, good afternoon all of my name is Sohil Mayur, IDVC 155. Next slide.
Start any problem?
Yes. Group E, business building. This group include any building or part of building which is used for purpose such as transaction of business, keeping of account and record, etc. Business building are banks, office, barber shop, beauty parlor, lunch counter, etc. Group F, masonized building. This includes any building of part of building which is used shop, stores, markets for display and scale, sale of merchandise, either wholesale or retail. Group G, industrial building. This includes any building or part of building or structure in which product of material of all kinds and kits and properties are fabricated assembly process. The example of this building are factories, workshops, laboratories, pumping station, refineries, gas plant, mills, dairies, etc. Group H, storage building. This group of building includes those structures which are primarily meant for storage of goods, products where merchandise, vessels, animals, etc. The example of this building are cold storage, where house, transit, seed, go down, garage, hangars, etc. The group J, builders building. This group includes all those building or structure which are used for storage, handling and manufacture of processing of material which are commercialized, labeled to burn off, explode and through hair doors. Hazard may be due to fire gases, fumes, inhalation, etc. And they include magazines specially prepared stores etc. Thank you for listening me. And next is Vignesh, IDVC 170.
Okay, sir, my ID number is 170. My topic is classification based on structure. There are three types of building: load bearing structure, frame structure, and composite structure. First one is load bearing structure. It is a structure comprising of slabs, beams, and load bearing wall. Most of the residential buildings are small in size and are up to three story, are generally constructed as load bearing structure. In load bearing structure, thickness of walls reduced from ground floor to first floor. And so on, as load reduced on walls vertically from ground floor to first floor and first floor to second floor and so on. As a result, compared to upper floors, the carpet area at the lower floor will be less. Such type of structure are most secured where hard substitute of soil is available at solo depth. Generally, individual residential bungalow, tenement, low-rise flats, temple, and rural building are constructed as load-bearing structure. Next, frame structure. It is structure comprising of slab, resting of beams, and supported by a network column. In this structure, all the wall may not partition wall as none of them bear any load and rest on plinth beams without foundation. As partition wall can be shifted easily anywhere on floor, more flexibility is available while the planning is frame structure. RCC is the most suitable material to withstand external loads like compressive, tensile, torsion, and shear along with moment. So all frame structure are constructed with RCC. All the column, beams, and slab are connected rigidly and are constructed monolithically. Example, multi-storied building and high-rise building. Next topic will explain Ritwik Prajapati, ID number 158. Thank you.
Yes, my name is Prajapati Ritwik, ID number 20C158, composite structure. The structure construct with combination of both load bearing structure is called composite structure. As shown in figure, the load of slab is transmitted to the slab soil below ground by load bearing walls and column through their foundation. In this type of structure, external walls are reared as load bearing wall and all intermediate support are in the form of RCC column. There are prepared for the buildings having large span such as workshop, all warehouse, large factories, shed, ground, godowns, its and have advantage of both load bearing structure as well frame structure. Next, building component and their function. A building has two main components, substructure or foundation and superstructure. The portion of the building below the surrounding ground is termed as substructure, and the portion of the building above the ground is known as superstructure. Next. Substructure of foundation. Substructure of foundation is the lower portion of the building, usually constructs below the ground level, which transmits the load of the superstructure to the subsoil. The soil which located immediately below the base of the foundation is called the subsoil or foundation soil, while the lowermost portion of the foundation which is in direct contact with the subsoil is contact the footing. A foundation is therefore the part of the structure which is direct contact with ground to which the load are transmit. Thus, base function of substructure or foundation is to transmit the dead loads, superimposed load, wind load for a building, the soil on which the building rests. The foundation is thus the most important part of a building. Next topic is ID number VC120.
Hi, myself Chaki. I mean, my ID number is 20C120. My topic. Hello. Hello.
Yes,
sir. Network issue, yes, here.
No, you are not clearly audible.
Hello.
Hello, everyone. Voice is clear or not?
Yes, sir.
No.
Yes, sir.
Hello, 120 number.
Yes.
Sir, you both, your audio is not visible.
Hello.
Yes, hello.
Yes, sir.
Continue, sir.
Now, what do you mean?
Yes, sir. Continue.
Hello, are you audible?
Yes, yes. Continue.
Network issue, sir. Here.
Okay. Continue.
Okay, sir. स्लाइड देख रही
प्लीज कंटिन्यू 120 एनीथिंग प्रॉब्लम
slide. Hello. Superconstruction is that part of the structure. Superstructure is the part of the structure which is above the ground. Following are structural component of the superstructure: lintel, walls, columns and beams, floors, basement, ground floor and upper floors, ceiling. Roof and slabs.
Okay. Next. Next group, scale presentation. Group number 7, 96 number, 97, 103, 112, and 113.
Yes, sir. 112. Ankit Baria. So screen is visible?
Yes. Start present.
Dear student and respected sir, I am Ankit Baria. My ID number is 23112 from Civil Engineering Department. I am going to present a presentation on chain serving topic. It is guided by Professor Dhaval Parmar sir and prepared by 23096-097-103-112-113. In topic content of chain serving. What, sir?
Presentation number. Okay. Got it.
112. Ankit Baria. Content is shown below. First, introduction. Second is principle of chain serving. Instrument of for training, function of instruments, advantage or disadvantage, procedure of chain serving, image and video of construction, okay, and reference. In introduction, chain survey is known, also called chain triangular. Chain surveying is that type of surveying in which only linear measurements are made in the field. This type of chain surveying is suitable for surveys of small extent on open ground to secure data or exact description of the boundaries or a piece of land or to take simple detail. Chain principle of chain surveying. The main principle of chain surveying is to provide a framework consisting of number of well conditional triangles or nearly equivalent triangles. It is useful to find the area of the field. So, second point is to work from the world to the path. Third is to fix the position of a new station by at least two independent processes. To choose a method of survey that is the most suitable for the purpose. To record field data carefully. And the next slide is presented by our group member 23096. His name is Om Jethwa. So I am invited 23096.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Om Jethwa. My ID number is 23096. Here are instruments for chaining like a chain or tape, arrows, pegs, ranging rods, offset rods, plasterers, lathes, whites, and plumb bob. There are function of instruments. Chains are used to measure horizontal distance. Chains are formed of straight links of galvanized milled steel wire bent into rings at the ends and joined each other by three small circular or oval wire rings. The ends of the chain are provided with brass handles for dragging the chain on the ground. The outside of the handle is the zero point of the chain, of the end point of the chain, and the length of the chain measured from the outside of one handle to the outside of the other. The length of a link is distance between the centers of the two consecutive middle rings. Arrows or making pins are made of tempered steel wire 4 mm in diameter, and generally 10 arrows are supplied with a chain. An arrow is inserted into the ground after the chain length is measured on the ground. Usually the length of an arrow is 14 cm and one end of it is made sharp and the other end is bent into a circle for facility of carrying. Now I request it to my group member Priyansu 20C103 for next slides.
Hello everyone. My name is Priyansu Patel. My ID number is 20C103. Today I present function of instrument. Third topic, pages. Wooden pages are used to mark the position of the station or terminal point of survey line. They are made of saw timber, generally 2.5 mm or 3 mm square and 50 mm long, taper at the end. They are driven in the ground with the help of wooden armor kept about 4 mm projecting above the surface. This is a picture of wooden pages, and we can show the diameter. Fourth, ranging rod. The ranging rod are used for making the position of chain order to make them visible at the distance. They are painted alternately black and white or red and white. They are made of old season straight grain timber teak. They are circular in cross section of 3 cm diameter and have a length of either 2.
Next
slide, open it. Sir. Yeah. Priyansu, next slide is visible?
Not. Restart, can you restart?
Visible,
3 cm length being more common. They are sewed at the bottom with a heavy iron points in order to make them visible at the distance. They are painted alternately black and white or red and white. Fifth, offset rods. And the offset rod is similar to a ranging rod and has a length of 3 meters. They are round wooden rods. Suit with a point iron C and end. The provided with a notch or hook at the order. The hook facility policing and polishing at the chain through huge and other obstruction. The road is mainly used for measuring rough offset nearby. It has also two narrow slots passing through the center of the section and set at the right angle to the another at the eye level for allowing the offset line. Sixth, plasterer lets in open level ground intermediate point on a line may also light out with straight lids, F to L meter long, made of soft wood. They are light both in color and weight, and can be easily carried about and sharpened with a knife will required. Seven, whities. Whities are pieces of sharpened thin stick cut from the nearest edge and are used for the same purpose as the lids. Though not satisfy in use, they are also useful in cross sectioning or in temporary marketing of counterpoint. Next, I request 20, ID number 2097 Virendra Parmar.
Who is the next? Virendra Parmar.
Hello, sir. My name is Virendra Parmar. My ID number is 20C097. Continue from function of plumb bob. While changing along sloping ground, a plumb bob is required to transfer the point to the ground. It is also used to make ranging pole vertical and to transfer point from a line ranger to the ground. In addition, it is used to use a centering aid to thyroidite, compass, plane rebel, and variety of other surveying instrument. Now advantage and disadvantage of chain surveying. Advantage: first, chain surveying is suitable for fairly level ground. Second, it does not require costly equipment. Third, it is used for preparing plans of a smaller area. Fourth, it is simple. Disadvantage: it is cannot use for large areas. It is also always accurate. Next, type of chain used in surveying: metric chain, steel band or bent chain, winter chain or survey chain, engineering chain, revenue chain. Next, I like to invite Mehul Ghadvi, ID number 20C113.
Hello, I'm Mehul Ghadvi, 20C113. We learn about types of chain, its advantage, disadvantage, instruments used for surveying, and structures of its instruments. Now we have to learn how to perform chain survey on field. Here in engineering, practical is more important than theory. So let's learn how to perform this practical procedure. उसकी क्या procedure होती है chain surveying? So यहाँ पे first step is two chain men are required in this process. The chain men are called as leader and follower. The chain men at the forward end of the chain is called leader, and chain man at the zero and rear end of the chain is called as follower. Fix station A and B at same distance by fixing wooden peg to determine horizontal distance between them. जो दो पॉइंट होते हैं उसे उसके लिए हमें वुडन पेग फिट करने का होते हैं. तो वो फिट करने के बाद पोजिशन ऑफ स्टेशन ए एंड बी इज फिक्स बाय मेजरिंग देयर पोजिशन फ्रॉम एट लीस्ट थ्री परमानेंट ऑब्जेक्ट एंड लोकेशन स्केच ऑफ स्टेशन ए एंड बी आर ड्रॉन. तो उसे ड्रॉ कर लेना ऑब्जेक्ट्स को स्केच कर. द फॉलोअर होल्ड्स वन हैंडल ऑफ द चेन कॉन्टेक्ट विथ पेग स्टेशन ए. तो हैंडल ए के अंदर स्टेशन ए के अंदर होगा. द लीडर टेक द अदर हैंडल ऑफ चेन एरोस एंड रेंजिंग रोड एंड इन फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन ड्रैगिंग चेन विद हिम. चेन को वो साथ लेके जाएगा फॉलो जो लीडर होगा वो. Next slide, please.
Next slide, open me.
Six. After the chain stretched completely along the line of the follow steps on one side of the line with the ranging rod touching the handle. अब जब स्ट्रेच फुल्ली स्ट्रेच हो जाएगी चेन तो उसको इस तरह सेट करना है. आफ्टर फॉलोइंग डायरेक्ट द लीडर टू स्टैंड एग्जैक्टली इन द लाइन द लीडर पुट स्ट्रेच एट द पोजीशन एंड इंसर्ट द एरो. बाद में उस चेन में एरो डाल के मेजर करने का होता है. ही देन मूव्स फॉरवर्ड विद द चेन हैंडल विद रिमेनिंग एरो एंड रेंजिंग रोड टिल फॉलोअर रीचेस द नेक्स्ट एरो पॉइंट. तो यहाँ से एक दो पॉइंट्स का हमने चेन सर्वे कैसे प्रैक्टिकल परफॉर्म करना है वो देखा. और ये छोटा सा वीडियो है उसमें सारा जितना अभी तक चला था वो सब था पीपीटी का ब्रीफ इंफॉर्मेशन. Okay, here is the video was stopped and next we will go for next slide.
Next slide is running.
I think I can't able to see next slide. Yeah, it's visible. Here, a reference we took from for this PPT is from Surveying Volume 1, Dr. B.C. Punamya Lakshmi Publication, Private Limited, and Basic Civil Engineering, Dr. R.P. Retharia, Patul Publication, and Google and YouTube. Some of them we took the reference from them. Hope you like it, and thank you so much. Thank you, sir, for guiding us and giving this chance to present a PPT.
Very good. Yeah. Presentation is nice to understand about the chain survey. Okay. Also, is big interactive presentation. Okay. Very good. And nice video is also very nice to understand the procedure, how we use the chain survey in a real field. Okay. If you want to check that area of your surrounding.
Can I stop presenting, sir?
Yes, yes, you can. Yeah, so, nice presentation.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Yes, thank you,
thank you, sir.
Namaste, one, okay? Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Now, next is group number 8. Who is the presenter?
Hi sir, 20C1111.
Triple one.
Oh, yes.
So sir.
I will make you presenter. Now you can share your screen.
Wait, no, sir, 1 minute. Can you see? Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Bharudra Prasad, Division 2.
Can anyone see? It was accurate.
1 minute.
Okay, now. Your video is?
Now?
Yes. Now open your question.
Wait, I'll start again.
Okay, very good.
One minute, sir. The PPT has been deleted.
Okay. There is a history in a PowerPoint, check it and try to see. If you search it, then stop sharing because your chats are not visible to all of us.
Okay.
Stop sharing and open presentation, and after that, you can share your presentation.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Paludia Krushi, ID number 20C111. Thanks from our group to our guide, Professor Dhaval sir. Today, our group give presentation about on compass survey. In this presentation, we should give presentation on introduction, aim study, objectives, etc. Introduction. Compass surveying. The branch of surveying in which we use compass for determination and bearing is called compass survey. Bearing, an angle and survey line which a specific direction is known as bearing. Instrument for the direct measurement of direction, survey compass and primacy compass. Instruments for measurement of angles, sextant and theodolite. Aim of study: to measure hearing of survey times and finding the include angles between them. Objectives: compass surveying is a type of surveying in which the direction of surveying lines are determined with a magnetic compass and the length of the surveying lines are measured with a tape or chain or lesser range finder. The compass is generally used to turn a traverse line. Compass. The compass cannot measure angle between two lines directly, but can measure an angle of a line with reference to magnetic meridian at the instrument station point is called magnetic bearing of line. Principle of compass surveying. The principle of compass surveying is traversing, which involves a series of connected lines. The magnetic bearing of the lines are measured by primatic compass and the distance of the measured by chain. Compass surveying is recommended when the area is large, undulating and crowded with many details. Now I request to Arpit to presentation next topic.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Arpit Patel. Prismatic compass element. Prismatic compass 117. Cylindrical metal box. Cylindrical metal box is having diameter of 8 to 12 centimeters, protects the compass and forms entire casing of body of the compass. The protect compass from dust, rain, etc. Pivot. Pivot is provided at the center of compass and supported freely suspended magnetic needle over it. Lifting pin and lifting lever. A lifting pin is provided just below the side vane. When the side vane folded, it pressed the lifting pin. The lifting pin will, the help of lifting lever, then lifts the magnetic needle out of pivot point to prevent damage of the pivot head. Magnetic needle. Magnetic needle is the heart of instrument. This needle measures angle of line from magnetic meridian, as the needle always remains pointed towards north-south pole at two points of needle when freely suspended any support. Graduated circle or ring. This is an aluminum graduated ring marked with 0 to 362, measures all possible bearing of lines and attached with the magnetic needle. The rings is graduated to half a degree. Prism. Prism is the used to read graduation on ring and take exact reading by compass. It is placed exactly opposite to object vane. The prism hole is protected by prism cap to protect it from dust and moisture. Next page. Prismatic compass. Object vane. Object vane is diametrically opposite to the prism and eye vane. The object vane is carrying a horsehair or black thin wire to sight object in line with eyesight. Eye vane. Eye vane is the slit provided with eye hole at bottom to bisect the object from slit. Glass cover. It is the cover the instrument box from the top such that needle and graduated ring seen from the top. Sunglass. There are used when some luminous object are to be bisected. Reflecting mirror. It is used to get image of an object located above or below the instrument level while bisection. It is placed on the object vane. Spring brake or brake pin. to damp the oscillation of the needle before taking a reading to bring to rest quickly. The light spring brake attached to the box brought in contact with the edge of the ring by gently pressed inward the brake pin. Next page. KP. Cruci, next page.
કયું
નથી રહ્યું
મારે આમ આવી ગયો
આ ટેમ્પરરી એડજસ્ટમેન્ટ ઓફ પ્રિઝમેટિક કપર્સ ધ ફોલોઈંગ પ્રોસિજર શુડ બી એડોપ્ટેડ આફ્ટર ફિક્સિંગ ધ પ્રિઝમેટિક કમ્પાસ ઓન ધ ટ્રિપોડ ઓર મેઝરિંગ ધ બેરિંગ ઓફ અ લાઇન સેન્ટર ઇઝ ધ ઓપરેશન ઇન વિચ કમ્પાસ ઇઝ કેપ એક્ઝેક્ટલી ઓવર ધ સ્ટેશન ફ્રોમ where the bearing is to be determined. The centering is checked by dropping a small pebble from the underside to the compass. If the pebble falls on the top, the peg when the centering is correct. If not, then the centering is correct by adjusting the leg or tripod. Leveling of compass is done. Circular ring of the ball and socket arrangement on the tripod will help to achieve proper level by rolling round pencil over the glass door. Focusing the prism, it move up or down in its side till the graduation on the aluminium ring are seen clear, sharp, and perfect focus. The position of the prism will depend upon the vision of the observer. Next page. Observing of bearing line. Consider a line AB of which the magnetic bearing is to be taken by fixing the ranging rod at station B. We get the magnetic bearing of needle for the enlarged portion gives actual pattern of graduation mark on ring. Next exercise. Next 126. Akash Singh.
Hello, good morning, good afternoon, sir. Sir, my name is Akar Singh and my ID number is 20C126. Let us talk about surveyor compass. The surveyor compass, it is a similar to a prismatic compass, except that it is has a only plane eye still instead of eye slit with prism and eye hole. This compass is having pointed needle in the place of broad thumb needle as in case of prismatic compass. Next. Let us talk about the difference between prismatic compass and the surveyor compass. Prismatic compass, the magnetic needle of the prismatic compass is broad type, whereas in surveyor compass it is edge bar type. The graduated card ring is attached with the needle. The ring does not rotate along with the line of sight. While in surveyor compass, the graduated card is attached to the box and not in the needle. The card rotates along with the line of sight. While in prismatic compass, the graduation in whole circle bearing system have 0 degree at south and 90 degree at west, 180 degree at north and 270 degree at east. While in surveyor compass, the graduation are in QB system having 0 degree at north and south and 90 degree at east and west. East and west are interchanged. In prismatic compass, the graduation are engraved in inverted. While in surveying compass, the graduation are engraved erect. In prismatic compass, the object main consists of metal vane with a vertical hair. While in surveying compass, the object main consists of a metal vane with a vertical hair. The eye vane consists of a small vane which slit in prismatic compass. While in surveyor compass, the eye vein consists of metal vein with a fine slit. In prismatic compass, the reading is taken with the help of a prism provided at the eyesight. While in surveying compass, the reading is taken directly swinging through the top of the glass. In prismatic compass, sighting and reading taking can be done simultaneously from one position of the observer. While in surveying compass, sighting and reading taking cannot be done simultaneously from one position of the observer. In prismatic compass, the tripod may or may not be provided. The instrument can be used even by holding suitably in hand. While in surveyor compass, the instrument cannot be used without a tripod. Next. Next. Bearing. The bearing of a line is the horizontal angle which it makes with a reference line, meridian. Meridian means that it is a north or south direction. Depending upon the meridian, there are four types of bearing. Let us talk about that four type. First is true bearing. The true bearing of a line is horizontal angle between the true meridian and the survey line. The true bearing is measured from the true north in the clockwise direction. The second, magnetic bearing. The magnetic bearing of a line is the horizontal angle which the line makes with the magnetic north. Third, grid bearing. The grid bearing of a line is the horizontal angle which line makes with the grid meridian. Fourth, arbitrary bearing. The arbitrary bearing of a line is the horizontal angle which line makes with the arbitrary meridian. Next. Working of a surveyor compass. First one is centering, second one is leveling, third one is observing the bearing of a line. First two observations are same as prismatic compass, but third observation differs from that. Fourth, observing the bearing of a line. In this compass, the reading is taken from the top of the glass and under tip of the north and of the magnetic needle directly. No prism is provided here. Next. Let us talk about the designation of bearing. The bearing are designed in the following two systems. First, whole circle bearing, and second is quadrilateral bearing system. I would like to invite 20C114 about the next presentation. Thank you.
The bearing of a line measured with respect to magnetic meridian in clockwise direction is called magnetic bearing, and its value varies between 0 to 360 degrees. The quadrant start from the north and progress in the clockwise direction, as the first quadrant is 0 to 90 degrees in clockwise direction. Second, 90 to 180 degrees. Third, 180 to 270 degrees, and up to 360 degrees is the first four quadrant. Next. Next. In this system, the bearing of survey lines are measured with respect to the north line or south line, whichever the nearest to the given survey lines, and either in clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction. Reduced bearing, RB. When the whole circle bearing is converted into quadrilateral bearing, it is termed as reduced bearing. Thus, the reduced bearing is similar to the quadrilateral bearing. It values lines between 0 to 90 degrees. But the quadrilateral should be maintained for the proper designation. The following table should be recommended for the conversion of whole circle bearing to radius bearing. WCB of any line. 0 to 90 degree first quadrant, RB barabar WCB. North, east. 90 to 180 degrees second quadrant, RB barabar 180 degrees to 180 degrees minus WCB. South to east, 180 degrees to 270 degrees third quadrant, RB barabar WCB minus 180 degrees south to west. 270 degrees to 360 degrees fourth quadrant, RB barabar 360 degrees minus WCB. North to west. Next. Core bearing and back bearing. The bearing of a line measured in the forward direction of survey lines is called the core bearing of that time, of that line. The bearing of a line measured in direction backward to the direction of progress of survey lines is called back bearing of the line. Core bearing barabar back bearing plus or minus 180 degrees. Back bearing barabar core bearing plus or minus 180 degrees. Plus sign is applied when forward core bearing is less than 180 degrees. Minus sign is applied when core bearing is greater than 180 degrees. In the quadrantal bearing system, the core bearing and back bearing are numerically equal, but the quadrant are just opposite. For example, if the bearing of AB and AB is
good afternoon, sir. My name is Kashyap Patel. Well, hello. May I audible?
Yes. Okay.
This is full case study of calculation of include two angles. I request to start the video. Start the video.
Sir, there is an issue to start a video.
Okay, next page.
Start.
Full case study.
Okay, you can explain.
Who can explain?
In this video, you share with your classmate. Okay?
Move at next page.
Hello, 111 number. Please. Nothing. Okay, any explanation from 23-128 number?
Yes, sir. Okay. Advantage of compass surveying. Hello.
Yes, hello.
Sir, some network issues. Now we're okay. Advantage of compass surveying. They are portable to light weight. Second, they have a favor to setting to fix on the session. The error detection produced in single survey line does not affect to other line. It is suitable of detect to all surveys. Second, disadvantage of compass surveying. It is less precise compared to other advanced method of surveying. It is easily subjected to various errors such errors. Adjoining magnetic meridian, local attraction, etc. Second, error in compass surveying. Error can be absent due to various reasons during to progress survey of surveying. They are classified as one, instrumental error. Second, personal error. Third, natural error. Okay, references. Dr. B.C. Punima, Ashok Kumar Jain, Arun Kumar Jain, and Google. Thank you for listening to our presentation, and thank you for giving great opportunity. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Very good. Okay, so compass surveying and there are different types of compass. The method used for the traversing purpose and for the surveying purpose is discussed here, and the procedure here from that temporary adjustment, and how to carry out and how to measure the bearing using the prismatic compass and the survey compass that we know. And that video is shown by the student. It is also very informative for us to how to perform a compass survey. Okay, so this very good presentation overall and very nice presentation. Okay, so very good. Now next presentation. Now we take
sir.
Yes, hello.
Sir, can I leave? I have to take my mom to the vaccination center.
Okay, now we take a break. Okay, about 45 minutes. Then after 45 minutes, we start with the group number 9. Okay, so we have 45 minutes break. We join after 45 minutes. Okay.
Sir, kela age join thavanu?
After 45 minutes. 2 and 15 minutes. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I will download your attendance first. after 45 minutes, everybody needs to join lecture. Okay. Can you take a lunch and join after 45
minutes? And then level your colleague, hi, yes, sir.
Yes, yes. Okay, now we join after 45 minutes.
જોઈન કેટલા વાગે થવાનું?
join with each other.
So